The first week we had backup, we put Lucky in a separate room because we didn't want to stress backup too much in the beginning. He didn't want to eat the first day we had him because he was stressed out from being separated from his family. He's totally over it now, and 2 days ago we started putting Lucky back into the living room. We had to keep them separated at all times though, because backup isn't scared of Lucky yet, and he'll go to her even when she's threatening and attacking him. So right now, Lucky is the one who could injure backup and not vice versa. In order to allow backup and Lucky to be in the same room without getting hurt, we put Lucky on his bench whenever we're home. Lucky can only stay on the bench whenever there's supervision, because if she would fly off and her long legs would be too long, she would hang upside down, and if she wouldn't be able to pull herself up again, she would die. That's why you can never put your bird of prey on a high stick or something. When we leave the house, backup goes in the bench and we put Lucky on the ground in the living room. We considered putting Lucky in the bench whenever backup's loose in the house, but I feel putting her on the bench is better for her because that way she doesn't have to see bars all the time. I just don't want to give her the feeling she needs to live in a cage all the time. So, this is the second step so far. When backup is calm, she doesn't threaten him anymore. In the beginning, when she was playing around the house, she would threaten him, as you can see here, but that's getting better as well, as you can see in a few seconds.
Kan elkaar.
Looking at the bottle, and then the dog, and then later looking at the bottle again. What do you mean the bottle didn't move all on its own? Was it really the dog pushing it forward?